was spiritually undesirable to God. Revelation chapter 3, verse 16 says, "So then, because thou art lukewarm, and neither cold nor hot, I will spew thee out of my mouth."
Yes.
The reason for this is because God has called you to be the salt of the earth.
Amen.
But once you lose your flavor,
yes,
you will no longer be satisfying to God. Going back into the text now, Luke chapter 18, verse 18 says, "A certain ruler asked him, saying, 'Good master, what shall I do to inherit eternal life?'" He is basically asking Jesus, "What can I do for your glory? What can I do for your glory?" Jesus responds by saying, "Thou knowest the commandments. Do not commit adultery, do not kill, do not steal, do not bear false witness, honor thy father and thy mother." This man's response to Jesus, he responds to Jesus by saying, "All these have I kept from my youth up." He basically tells Jesus that he has been faithful to his commandments from when he was a child. Jesus, in return, basically says, "You're missing the point. I want you to sell everything that financially defines who you are. I want you to abort your reputation. I want you to sacrifice your success. I want to move you into a place in your life that you've never been before. That way, you will have no other choice but to trust me." Is there anybody who has ever experienced a dark place in your life where you had no options but to trust Jesus? There was no other way, there was no other decisions but Jesus. Hallelujah, Lord God. Proverbs chapter 3, verses 5 and 6 says, "Trust in the Lord with all of thine heart, and lean not unto thine own understanding. In all of thine ways acknowledge him, and he shall direct your path."
Yes.
Psalms chapter 37, verse 25 says, "I have been young, and now am old,
yes,
and have not seen,
yes,
the righteous forsaken,
yes,
nor his seed begging bread."
Yes.
It's interesting how we can become our own distractions and miss God. We can become our own distractions and miss the glory.
Yes.
This particular man had missed the glory because he was distracted by his financial gain, which leads me to believe that you have to be willing to give up the things that you value the most, so in order to obtain what matters, what values the most, or rather who values the most. We have to learn how to practice doing the least expected. We have to learn how to practice doing the unthinkable to get to where Jesus is. There were certain people in the Bible that had done the unthinkable. And there was one particular woman who exercised this. There was the woman with the issue of blood. She had done the unthinkable because she heard that Jesus was in the area and there was a large crowd surrounding him. So she got on her hands and knees and began to crawl to her miracle. She began to crawl to her breakthrough. I want to emphasize, sometimes in order to obtain what you're looking for,
yes,
you're going to have to exercise the unthinkable.
Yes.
The next person in the Bible who exercised the unthinkable was Joshua, meaning the Lord is salvation.
Yes.
Joshua was in the heat of battle, and he was fighting against five kings and five armies. And so now Joshua, he is swinging and he is ducking. I dare you to do a motion as if you're swinging. Don't act like you've never been in a fight before. Joshua Joshua finds himself swinging and ducking. He's swinging and ducking, and he was concerned about the time of day. Hallelujah, Jesus. He was concerned about the time of day, so he asked the Lord to hold the sun in place. I marvel at this, because in order for God to hold the sun in place so that he can see his enemies, scientifically speaking, the world rotates at 1,000 miles per hour. So I want you to imagine how God stops the world. What happens is, if you stop the world from spinning right now, buildings collide with buildings, trees collide with trees, because you're coming to a dead stop from 1,000 miles per hour. But the Bible says this was the only time that God hearkened unto the voice of man. And so he stopped time. Not only was the earth, the gravitational effects of the earth was still intact, but now you've affected the other planets. I know this is maybe too deep, but now God has to stop the other planets from rotation. God has to stop the schedule of the alliance of other planets, all so that Joshua can defeat his enemies. I'm talking about you exercising the unthinkable, praying for the unthinkable. Hallelujah, Jesus. A next person in the Bible who exercised this was King Hezekiah. King Hezekiah got word from the prophet. He got word that he was going to surely die. He got word from God through the prophet that he was going to surely die. But then something remarkable happens. He turns to the wall. He turned his face to the wall, which leads me to believe, in some cases, you can't turn to family. In some cases, you can't turn to your doctors. In some cases, you can't turn to your job. In some cases, you can't turn to your landlord. In some cases, you can't turn to family. You can't turn to friends. King Hezekiah, in his horrible situation, he turns to the wall. Tell somebody, who do you turn to when there's nothing else left to turn to? Who are you turning to when friends turn their backs on you? Who do you turn to when people talk about you? Who do you turn to? He about faces to the wall, and he cries out with a loud voice. He says, Lord. He says, Lord. And God turned the situation around in his Jesus wanted him to sacrifice his finances. He wanted him to sacrifice the thing he valued the most. All Jesus wanted was for him to sacrifice something good in exchange for something greater. Would you sacrifice whatever good thing you have for something greater? The word of God declares, greater is he that is in me than he that is in the world. I dare you to give God praise for what he's about to do in your life. I dare you to give God praise for what he's about to do for your finances, for your doctor report, for the court report, for whatever it is that you're standing in need of. Been working.